Hello, and welcome to the 2021 Annual Campus Award Ceremony. Thank you for joining me for this special event. I want to recognize first and foremost that we have been living through extraordinary times. For over a year, campus life has looked different. We have excelled at offering classes in hybrid and remote formats, conducting research remotely, and learning how to do our jobs in new ways. There is finally light on the horizon. Many members of our campus community have become eligible for the vaccine. We are planning for a more dynamic fall semester, filled with the in-person experiences that we missed so much over the last year. We have much to look forward to, but we also have so much to celebrate from the past year. Thanks to the tireless efforts of our community, we have continued to make progress on many of our strategic goals. We recently celebrated the reopening of our expanded Mosaic and LGBTQ plus resource center. Thanks to the generous support of the Anschutz Foundation, we are making plans to expand our engineering building with a 24,000 square foot annex. Our new Bachelor of Arts in Inclusive Early Childhood Education will help to fill a critical shortage of teachers in our state and nation. We were recently named one of the most military-friendly public universities in the entire country. And perhaps most importantly, we're carrying forward the lessons we have learned during the pandemic. We're working hard to strengthen our online learning experiences. We're weaving mental health and wellness efforts into the fabric of our campus. And we have learned the importance of practicing compassion, empathy, and flexibility each and every day. The optimism, resilience, and hard work of our campus community has made so much of our good news possible. I'm grateful for each one of you. I also want to recognize accomplishments that in past years, we might not have taken the time to celebrate. Our faculty, staff, and students are balancing more commitments than ever. Some days, it can feel that it takes extraordinary effort to achieve ordinary things. Yet, each day, you give your time, talent, and energy to create a community that we can all be proud of. These accomplishments are worthy of celebrating. In my eyes, each faculty, staff, and student deserves an award this year for standing strong in our values as a university and a community. In this spirit of thanks and gratitude, I am overjoyed to celebrate the accomplishments of our faculty, staff, students, and alumni today. Now, we have a number of awards to present and many folks to recognize, so let's get started. I would first like to recognize a special group of faculty members who have given more than 40 years of service to the campus, the Campus Legacy Builders. This year, we have one inductee, Dr. Daphne Greenwood, in the College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences. Thank you, Daphne, for your long service and your many contributions to the university. Today, I'll be joined virtually by some special people to help present several awards. The first award will be presented by David Weiss, President of Faculty Assembly, recognizing the Faculty Assembly Service Award.
Hi, I would like to present the 2021-2022 Faculty Assembly Service Award to Dr. Maya Krakowiak in the Department of Communication. And this award is about service to the campus and faculty assembly and higher levels of service to faculty council and its associated committees. And Dr. Krakowiak has served as faculty assembly vice president, president, and past president at UCCS. But she's also served as vice chair of the faculty council, which is a CU system level committee representing faculty of all of the campuses. And this year they worked really hard on inclusiveness issues on our campuses, as well as the online initiative for the CU campuses. And Dr. Krakowiak was instrumental in making sure that the faculty voice was really heard for this whole online initiative for our campus and the other campuses. And for that, for making sure that the faculty voice is being heard, for being on so many of the online initiative committees and leading the faculty charge there, and making sure that we have faculty buy-in for these new programs, we'd really like to award her for the Faculty Assembly Service Award. Well done. And now I would like to introduce Miranda Baumgarten for students. She's going to present the Students' Choice Award for Educator of the Year, and she's an SGA Senator for Nursing and Health Sciences. Thank you.
Thank you. I am pleased to present the Educator of the Year Award to instructor Christy McCann. I had the pleasure of being enrolled in Professor McCann's Introduction to Chemistry and Introduction to Organic and Biochemistry courses in the fall and this spring. Throughout these courses, I was continuously grateful and impressed by Instructor McCann. Her commitment to her students' education and her own, while accommodating the challenges presented by the pandemic, all the while being loyal and caring of her family, is astonishing and worth the acknowledgement. As a student in her class, I was able to compare this learning environment with my other courses and can confidently say that the structure of her class has been the best this entire year. Instructor McCann offers a high-flex learning environment with short online topic-based lectures, many guided practice worksheets, extra videos to help deepen our understanding of a concept, and coordinated weekly study sessions with the Science Center to give us, the students, even more resources to excel in this class. Her idea to incorporate short topic-based video lectures allows students to learn before attending classes so that we can maximize our time during the scheduled lecture to practice and ask our questions. I nominated Instructor McCann for Student Educator of the Year on the Student Government 2021 election ballot after being extraordinarily impressed by her. During a chemistry lab announcement, Instructor McCann shared that she had worked on her graduate thesis with advice from her professor and was offered an amazing opportunity to accompany her professor to present their ideas to City Council in Denver. This announcement puts into perspective the work Instructor McCann has done in the year that I have had the pleasure of knowing her, but I can only imagine what she has accomplished as an instructor at this university. Reflecting back on the year, she had provided extra video content and extra practice worksheets for students who requested the extra help. She records our in-class lectures in order for students to go back and rewatch lectures, which I have not yet had an instructor do besides her. Instructor McCann had her family introduced in a few video lectures due to school closures and online learning. Her dedication to the class when her family might be impacted is admirable. The story about her thesis left an impression that not only is she an outstanding teacher, but she is also still a student. As a student, she excels going further in her own education while leaving a remarkable impression on students' learning and her family. From a student's perspective, Instructor Christy McCann has worked diligently and thoroughly to provide for her students, her family, and even herself. I can't think of a more deserving candidate for this award than Instructor Christy McCann. And now, Carlos Garcia, Vice Chancellor of Student Affairs, will present the Student Achievement Award.
Thank you, Miranda. I'm here to present the Student Achievement Award, which is an annual award that has been in existence since 1982. It is my honor to present this award to one student who has excelled in both of the following areas: made a significant personal accomplishment in conjunction with earning a degree, and made a substantial contribution to the quality of student life at UCCS. This year's recipient is Gwyneth Rosenkram. Now let me tell you a little bit about Gwen. Gwyneth Rosenkram is graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in Human Services. Gwyneth is a Chancellor's Leadership Class Scholar, a Live Leader, and performed as Clyde, the UCCS mascot, and competed with an on-campus esports team. You could even spot Gwen performing improv comedy at Clyde's and at the End Center for the Arts. Gwen is just as involved off campus as they are on campus. Off campus, Gwen runs Colorado Springs' only LGBTQ+ improv troupe, shining light on diversity within comedy. They've created a wide variety of accessible arts programs for kids around Colorado Springs, including performing at arts summer camps and after-school classes. Gwen works as a simulated patient for the Paramedic Academy at Penrose Hospital, hoping to train paramedics to respond empathetically to transgender patients. They write and perform stand-up as well as sketch comedy for multiple programs, including Science Riot, an educational program which are working to amplify the voices of scientists across the country. Gwen also teaches comedy classes for Rice Comedy in Denver, their favorite comedy theater. Gwyneth made their mark at UCCS through their work advocating for a more diverse, equitable, and inclusive environment. Gwen grappled with chronic physical and mental health hurdles, switching majors from English to inclusive elementary education, ultimately earning a degree in human services. They are thankful for the support they have had in finishing school. Gwyneth is proud to be the first openly transgender student to receive the Student Achievement Award. It is no doubt that Gwen has left a legacy here at UCCS and made an impact on creating a campus that is more diverse, equitable, and inclusive. Thank you, Gwen, for your commitment to UCCS and to our community. You are an exceptional representative of the UCCS student body, and I am honored to present you with this award. I wish you continued success in all that you do in the future and applaud you for your accomplishments thus far. Congratulations. Next up, Jane, Mark, and Sarah Wisner will present the Ron Wisner Human Spirit and Leadership Award. Thank you.
Thank you and good evening. Once again, our family is honored to participate in the UCCS Campus Award Ceremony. Selecting and presenting the Ron Wisner Human Spirit and Leadership Award is always a highlight of our year. It is always exciting to meet such amazing students, even if it has to be virtual. To begin tonight, we would like to recognize the other members of the selection committee, which is comprised of UCCS faculty, administrators, and staff, several of whom were also former students and who all collaborated with Dean Wisner during his time at UCCS. And I think uniquely, also includes the inaugural recipient of the Ron Wisner Human Spirit and Leadership Award. Each member provides unique personal insights into Dean Wisner's legacy at UCCS. We would also like to recognize the hard work of the candidate nominators in ensuring such a legacy lives on at UCCS. As we get further from Dr. Wisner's time at UCCS, we realize that fewer and fewer people on campus know of his legacy. So I'd like to spend a brief moment to introduce the who and why of this award. Dr. Ron Wisner came to UCCS in 1979 and served principally as Dean of Students, he would have preferred Dean for Students, until 2003. During this time at UCCS, he was known as a student champion. An overarching theme of his UCCS tenure was to encourage students to achieve their individual and community potential. His aim was to not only prepare students to move successfully into their careers, but to prepare them to be citizens of the world. In all students, he saw the capability to thrive in leadership roles and strove to empower all students to seek out leadership opportunities. Outside of time with family, Ron liked nothing more than to explore and immerse himself in other cultures. He championed the ideals of diversity and inclusion, not just of people, but also of thought and experiences. I know today he would be most encouraged by the resolve of student leaders who continue to demand these principles. Now, more than ever, we need more of the ground-up leadership style he championed. In recognizing just such a student, we are excited to honor Courtney Hamrick as the 2021 Ron Wisner Human Spirit and Leadership Award winner. She exemplifies the leadership principles of vision, integrity, positive actions, and building relationships that Dr. Wisner championed.
Okay, Courtney, now we get to talk a little bit about you. Courtney Hamrick is a junior in the Bachelor of Innovation in International Business degree program with a minor in Japanese language and culture. While at UCCS, she has worked in the Excel Languages Center as operations and assessment manager, where she is the frontline administrator, and her impact has been overwhelmingly positive. In this leadership position, she has inspired other student leaders to work in the center. Courtney has been instrumental in tutoring Japanese students of all ages, using a variety of techniques she developed to help the students become successful in their studies. Since she is unable to travel right now, she broadens her perspective by consuming media from other parts of the world and enjoys studying French, German, Italian, and Spanish.
Courtney also enjoys a variety of recreational activities. She practices yoga, Tai Chi, skiing, and swimming. She loves to hike with her dog, Moab, and has a passion for rehabilitating dogs that are categorized as unadoptable. Moab is her third successful dog rescue. She also assists in socializing cats and kittens who have been designated for euthanasia so that they are adoptable as well. Congratulations, Courtney, on this award. We're happy to award you this. And now we would like to introduce Nathan Gibson, Executive Director of Athletics, who will present the two Thomas F. McLaughlin Awards.
The Thomas F. McLaughlin Award has been presented annually to the top student athletes who have excelled in their sport, achieved in the classroom, have been a leader on their teams, and served their communities. These individuals represent the very best that Mountain Lion student athletes have to offer. This year, I am extremely proud to recognize Mallory Corrigan of the UCCS Women's Lacrosse Program and William Ross of the UCCS Track and Field Programs as the 2020-2021 Thomas F. McLaughlin Award recipients. One of the most decorated student athletes in program history, Will Ross has been recognized as a multiple-time All-American as a long and triple jump student athlete for the Mountain Lion Track and Field Program. Will has been recognized as an academic All-American, which puts him in a select class of student athletes who are All-Americans in their sport, as well as in the classroom. Will has also led his team to the first conference championships in program history, along with the highest national rankings in track and field in school history. Will has made an incredible impact on the track and field program, not only for his amazing accomplishments, but also because of his outstanding leadership. Will finishes with a degree in electrical engineering and has maintained an impressive 3.88 GPA. As a leader for the Mountain Lion Women's Lacrosse Program, Mallory Corrigan has also been an outstanding leader for the department, UCCS, and in the Colorado Springs community. Mallory has served as the president of the Student Athlete Advisory Committee and has led UCCS athletics to national recognition for community service efforts. Mallory has led numerous efforts for volunteering and has made a remarkable difference in the lives of those around her, as well as inspiring leadership and service among others within the department and campus. Mallory has also been an outstanding student athlete within the women's lacrosse program, including being named a multiple-time all-conference academic student athlete. Mallory will graduate with a 3.55 GPA in sports management with an entrepreneurship minor. Please join me in congratulating both Mallory and William as the 2020-2021 Thomas F. McLaughlin Award recipients. At this time, I would like to introduce Joanna Bean, Director of Alumni Relations in the Annual Fund, who will present the Alumni and Friends Award.
When Jane Dillon was cheering on the Mountain Lions at a UCCS basketball game, or meeting with a student at a KPWE Scholars event, or serving on one of several boards at UCCS, her enthusiasm for the campus and its students was so evident and so infectious that you might have assumed she was a UCCS alumna. She wasn't, but that didn't mean Jane Dillon wasn't one of the campus's most devoted supporters. For her boundless love for UCCS, Jane Dillon is the recipient of the 2021 UCCS Alumni and Friends Award. Jane, who passed away in November, is receiving the award posthumously. The award began in 1978 and recognizes individuals and organizations who have demonstrated a significant contribution to further the growth and development of UCCS. Martin Wood, Senior Vice Chancellor of Advancement at UCCS, said this about the decision to recognize Jane. "I am so pleased that Jane has been awarded the Alumni and Friends Award. Jane was very engaged and passionate about the campus and our students. Her support has clearly changed lives. While she will be dearly missed, her legacy will live on." Jane moved to Colorado Springs from New York in the late 1990s to be closer to one of her two sons and his family. While on the East Coast, she had been director of the Long Island Red Cross and active in the Republican Party. Jane was a Texan by birth, but her family would regularly visit Southern Colorado, and so Colorado was like a second home for her, according to her son, Keith. Keith said that the more his mother got involved in UCCS, the more she loved it. She wanted to see the campus grow and prosper and understood the significant impact a college education has for UCCS students and the impact the campus has on the community. Keith said this about his mother. She always got involved where she could help people succeed. Jane's involvement at UCCS spanned many areas. She served on the board of the Karen Pacell Women's Endowment Scholarship Program. She was chair of the UCCS School of Public Affairs Community Advisory Board, and she was a member of the TheaterWorks Advisory Board. Jane also was a trustee of the University of Colorado Foundation, and in 2018, she was named CU Advocate of the Year for her exceptional advocacy of CU and UCCS. Jane's financial contributions to UCCS included funding 18 scholarships and an endowment. Thank you, Jane, for your steadfast support of UCCS and your impact on our campus community, the local community, and the CU system. And now I would like to introduce Shannon Cable, Director of Student Employment, who will present the Student Employee of the Year Award.
It is my pleasure to recognize this year's Student Employee of the Year, Daylin Dennis. Daylin was selected by committee as the top example of the work that our amazing almost 1,800 plus student employees do each day. The competition for this award was extremely strong, with 11 students being nominated across many departments. We truly appreciate all of the efforts of our student employees and, of course, Daylin. Daylin works as the student simulation technician in the Clinical Simulation Learning Center in the Bethel College of Nursing and Sciences. And she previously worked as a barista for Sanatorium Grounds. In her current position, Daylin works to support students, faculty, and staff in planning, setting up, and supporting simulations. These patient experiences require precise responses that not only replicate responses from real situations, but guide the learner to a new understanding. Daylin's nominators describe her professionalism, flexibility, humor, problem solving, creativity, and initiative skills as qualities that quickly made her one of their most valuable staff members. Daylin's ability to collaborate, create, and take on new tasks while offering genuine work ethic and creating lasting relationships has created an effective and bright workplace. Daylin has the drive to succeed in a very challenging position during a time that requires constant innovation and adaptation. Daylin is a key factor in the success of the Clinical Simulation Learning Center and the success of our UCCS nursing students throughout her tenure, and especially during the pandemic. Daylin's impact literally made it possible for over 100 students to graduate from nursing with the required clinical hours during this pandemic. In closing, Daylin's colleagues recognize her as driven, dependable, creative, a true team player, and all of this citing her commitment to supporting others. In every respect, Daylin embodies the Student Employee of the Year. Please join me in congratulating Daylin Dennis, our 2020-2021 UCCS Student Employee of the Year. Hey, Daylin. Now, I would like to ask Joel Tanyan, Systems Librarian, Kramer Family Library, to present the Campus Sustainability Award.
Hi, everyone. I'm excited and honored to award the 2021 Campus Sustainability Award to Cynthia Norton. Cindy Norton is a hazardous material specialist for environmental health and safety. In this role, she has worked to clean up chemicals used in the science laboratories across campus, as well as a safe and responsible disposal of hazardous and toxic materials on campus. She also has coordinated toner and ink cartridge recycling and found ways to repurpose and redistribute lab chemicals that would otherwise be discarded. Cindy's guidance and support has been crucial too in helping academic departments meet green standards in their labs. Besides these official duties, Cindy also has been a vital member of the Campus Sustainability Committee over the years. She has played an integral role in the committee's strategic planning efforts, including serving as the chair of the Operations Subcommittee. Her input has been crucial in the sustainability tracking, assessment, and rating system review the campus undergoes every 3 years, helping UCCS earn an overall gold rating for its sustainability efforts. Cindy volunteers her expertise in other areas too. She assisted the director of the sustainability minor with updating and maintaining the program's website for a number of years. And she regularly shares her sustainability knowledge with others across campus. Cindy has also helped my department, the Kramer Family Library, with many recycling and hazardous materials questions as we've gotten rid of our aging microfiche collection. Finally, to quote the nominating letter I received for Cindy from David Havlick, professor in the Department of Geography and Environmental Studies, Cindy's hand is always first to rise whenever there's an opportunity to volunteer on campus. She has long been and continues to be a backbone of sustainability efforts at UCCS. Please join me in congratulating Ms. Norton on this well-deserved award. And now I would like to introduce Jesse Smith, Associate Vice Chancellor for Research, who will present the Faculty Award for Excellence in Research.
Hello, it is my pleasure to present the Faculty Award for Excellence in Research to Dr. Scott Trimboli, Associate Professor of Electrical and Computer Engineering. Dr. Trimboli is a highly acclaimed expert in control systems design, which includes predictive modeling, optimization, and higher power battery research. He has collaborated with industry and academic partners alike to computationally and experimentally create and validate control systems for advanced battery operations. His research is critical to the evolution of the transportation industry as it informs the infrastructure needed to support electric vehicles, including things like charging methodologies, on-demand battery life, and the extension of battery life. But it doesn't stop there. His basic science research on model predictive control has far-ranging translations to biomedicine, climate science, and even consumer electronics, just to name a few. Dr. Trimboli's path to UCCS took him around the world. He started here in Colorado Springs, earning his undergraduate degree from the United States Air Force Academy, before completing his PhD at Oxford. His journey took him to Germany, Florida, New York, and lucky for us, back to Colorado, where he worked in important industry and military-connected positions. He joined our faculty in 2011. Dr. Trimboli has authored and co-authored, at last count anyway, 16 scientific papers, a book, 3 patents, and too many to count presentations and reports. Most of his work includes student co-authors, and it's clear that he takes seriously his role in cultivating the research interest for the next generation of engineers. He has graduated 3 PhD students and co-mentored 6 additional PhD students since arriving at UCCS. He also engages actively in undergraduate research opportunities and takes care to translate his research knowledge into the classroom setting. To date, his team has received approximately $2.9 million for their research from agencies such as Department of Energy, NASA, Office of Naval Research, and the National Science Foundation. Most recently, Dr. Trimboli, with his longtime collaborator, Dr. Gregory Plett, were awarded over $700,000 by the NSF to support Aspire, which is an engineering research center led by Utah State for advancing sustainability through powered infrastructure for roadway electrification. Dr. Trimboli is bringing national recognition to UCCS for his revolutionary work in improving battery charging times and reducing battery degradation. What reviewers have to say about his work? Words like brilliant, eloquent, pioneer, exceptional researcher, sparks innovation. As one reviewer stated, he has consistently proven to be a highly valuable member of each research team and is unquestionably accepted as the expert on model predictive and related advanced control methods for battery systems. So please join me in congratulating one of our best, Dr. Trimboli, this year's winner for excellence in research. And now I would like to introduce Dave Anderson, Chair of the Award Selection Committee, to present the Outstanding Teacher Award.
It gives me great pleasure to pronounce Professor Kevin Tverdi from the Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry as this year's recipient of the UCCS Outstanding Teacher Award. Kevin has been at UCCS since 2013. And in that time, he has distinguished himself as an outstanding teacher and scholar. His nominator, Professor Janelle Owens, Associate Chair of the Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry, notes that Dr. Taverdi is a highly enthusiastic teacher, highly regarded by his students, and offers intellectually rigorous and challenging courses. We have shared many students in our courses, and those students have the highest regard for Dr. Taverdi. They value his intellect, his desire to help students learn, and his passion for teaching. I've had the opportunity to provide peer review of Dr. Taverdi's teaching, and I was hard pressed to come up with suggestions for improvement. He's that good. His lectures are well-paced, dynamic, engage students as active learners, incredibly detail-oriented, and thoughtful. Kevin's nomination also included several letters of support from students. Undergraduate student Sophia Zanoni says that Dr. Taverdi is as close to a perfect professor for me as one could get. He is incredibly enthusiastic about the subjects he teaches, and his passion rubs off on students, giving them a genuine desire to learn quantum mechanics and thermodynamics, a feat not easily achieved. Dr. Taverdi also always does his utmost to help his students, both with class and with more general issues. He's always open to answering questions, even outside of office hours. Graduate student Brennan Watts notes, whether giving a lecture or guiding a student through a new experiment, Dr. Taverdi is consistently passionate about what he does. His excitement rubs off on his students and entices them to engage more deeply with course materials or with research activities. Student comments on Kevin's FCQ forms were also uniformly flowing with praise. Over and over were exclamations of, "Great professor, I love this course," and "Hands down, the best instructor I've ever had." One I liked was, even though the course material is supposed to be very dense and boring, Dr. Taverdi made his lectures very inspiring and interesting, especially for an 8 a.m. class. And another, prior to taking physical chemistry, I was incredibly intimidated by the material. But I would say that while I'm walking out of physical chemistry with it having been one of the most difficult courses I've ever taken, it was also one of the most interesting. Thank you for turning this field from terrifying to amazing. Kevin, I am honored to present you with this award. Congratulations. Now I'd like to introduce Chancellor Reddy to present our final awards and wrap up today's virtual event. Thank you.
It is with great pleasure and excitement that I present the Chancellor's Award. This year's awardee is Professor of Health Sciences and Chair of the Health Sciences Department, Dr. Jackie Burning. This award, of course, has a special place in my heart. The Chancellor's Award recognizes a faculty member for outstanding teaching, research, and service. Each year, it celebrates an individual who dedicates themselves to the betterment of their field, the university, and those around them. I'm overjoyed to share just a few of the ways that Jackie has done so. Through teaching and service that has contributed to a culture of true excellence at UCCS. Over the past 25 years, Jackie has helped to build the university's academic programs in biology and exercise science from the ground up. Despite routinely teaching large introductory courses, often with over 300 students at a time, students report that Jackie is one of the best professors they have ever had. Dr. Burning has adapted to the challenges of teaching during COVID-19 with true aplomb. For example, she created an adaptive online learning program to help students improve their memory and recall of content delivered in class. Her passion for the material she teaches inspires her students, and her dedication to their own health leads to their lifelong betterment. As Jackie says, if she can teach students the science of food and nutrition in class, they will know how to eat for the rest of their lives. On top of a passion for outstanding teaching, Jackie is committed to service. There are far too many accomplishments to name, but I'll highlight a special project Jackie has advanced for the university: growing the vision for innovative programs in health and wellness outlined in the UCCS strategic plan. Dr. Berning was involved with every aspect of the William J. Hibble Sports Medicine and Performance Center, from selecting our clinical partner, Centura Health Systems, to picking paint colors for the student common areas. Our vision for the Hibble Center could not have been accomplished without Jackie's tireless efforts. And in the future, Dr. Berning is poised to make even more critical impacts on our campus. For instance, she's leading the effort to start a doctoral level physical therapy program at UCCS by 2024. I have no doubt that with Jackie's energetic and visionary leadership, she will not only accomplish, but exceed her goals. These accomplishments only scratch the surface of Dr. Jackie Berning's contributions to our university, our community, our state, and our world. Thank you, Jackie, for your service. We are so fortunate you are a part of the Mountain Lion family. Once again, congratulations on being recognized with the Chancellor's Award. And now it's time to present the Garrett Swasey Outstanding Staff Award. In 2016, the Outstanding Staff Award was renamed to honor Garrett Swasey, a UCCS police officer killed in the line of duty in November of 2015. This award is special to all of us here at the university. It acknowledges the exceptional achievements of a UCCS staff member who embodies excellence in service. Even more importantly, in the memory of Garrett Swasey, it celebrates a staff member who gives of their own self for the betterment of our community. It is with great pleasure that I announce this year's awardee is Prevention and Outreach Manager for the Office of Dean of Students, Ray Fisco. In these extraordinary times, when our students have been presented with so many challenges, Ray has stepped up as a leader for student advocacy and support. In everything he does, Ray is committed to making sure that our students are safe, healthy, and even well-fed. His work to make Clyde's Cupboard a reality has made fresh, healthy food available to students who are facing food insecurity. His work with the Smart Move UCCS campaign has helped our students and campus to be 99% free from DU offenses in the last 3 years. He even finds time to hold leadership positions on the national level and teach a GPS course to first-year students. What we celebrate most of all is Ray's compassion and empathy for our students. One of his colleagues shared that acts of kindness, like walking over a half a mile with a student so they did not feel alone while seeking counseling services in a moment of crisis, are normal for him. Ray often works with students as they face challenges and hardships that may feel insurmountable. He always seeks to help them rise above challenges and find their fullest potential. He's a shining example of the Mountain Lion spirit. In recognition of his leadership, selflessness, and service to the university, it is my honor to present Mr. Ray Fisco with this year's Garrett Swasey Award. Congratulations, Ray. It is so well deserved. Once again, thank you all for joining us virtually today. My congratulations to each of our award recipients. We are truly fortunate to celebrate each of these phenomenal individuals for their contributions to our campus community and beyond. Thank you. As I shared, this unusual year has shown the strength and resilience of our campus. Every student, faculty, and staff member has risen to the challenges of the COVID-19 era and shown that we Mountain Lions are truly stronger together. I'm so proud of our campus, and I can't wait to see where we go next. Thank you.